To a Poet 1,000 Years Hence by James Elroy Flecker. I, who am dead 1,000 years, and wrote this sweet archaic song, send you my words for messengers, the way I shall not pass along. I care not if you bridge the seas, or ride secure the cruel sky, or build consummate palaces of metal or of masonry. But have you wine and music still, and statues and a bright-eyed love, and foolish thoughts of good and ill, and prayers to them who sit above? How shall we conquer? Like a wind that falls at eve, our fancies blow, and old Maeonides the blind said it 1,000 years ago. O friend unseen, unborn, unknown, student of our English tongue, read out my words at night alone. I was a poet, I was young. Since I can never see your face, and never shake you by the hand, I send my soul through time and space to greet you. You will understand. To a Poet 1,000 Years Hence by John Heath Stubbs. I, who am dead 1,000 years, and wrote this crabbed post-classic screed, transmit it to you, though with doubts that you possess the skill to read. Who, with your pink mutated eyes, crouched in the radioactive swamp, beneath a leaking shelter, scan these lines beside a flickering lamp? Or in some plastic paradise of pointless gadgets, if you dwell, and finding all your wants supplied, do not suspect it may be hell. But does our art of words survive? Do bards within the swamp rehearse tales of the 20th century, nostalgic in rude epic verse? Or do computers churn it out, in lieu of songs of war and love, neat slogans by the state endorsed, and prayers to them who sit above? How shall we conquer? All our pride fades like a summer sunset's glow. Who will read me when I am gone? For who reads Elroy Flecker now? Unless, dear poet, you were born, like me, a deal behind your time, there is no reason you should read, and much less understand, this rhyme.